Yeah, good evening, everybody. So let's continue with the CMFB circuit. That's a common mode feedback, right? So, yeah, we need a common mode feedback for fully differential op-amp. Okay. Yeah, the fourth CMFB circuit is a switched capacitor circuit. See? Yeah, see. This is a op-amp output node. This is a CMFB voltage. So, I have a nominal bias VB here. And this is a common mode reference. Yeah, so I want to set common mode output voltage same as VCM rep. Okay. Yeah, see, in this case, see, we just switch those, during phi 1 phase. The switch, the inner switch is on during the phi 2 phase. This outer switch is on. Okay. So you will see during phi 2 phase, this C1 capacitor voltage will be charged to DC voltage. That is VB minus VCM rep. And then this charge is pumped into capacitor C2 during phi 1 phase. So this DC voltage, VB minus VCM rep, is pumped into this capacitor. So, yeah, so then see, we can see that this voltage, that's a voltage between two C2 capacitor in series. Those C2 voltage will be charged to VCM rep minus VB. Then, see, those two voltages are the same, C2 voltages. Then you can find out CMFB voltage is the voltage in the middle plus this VB minus VCM rep. Okay? Yeah, you'll see this one, see? For example, it's something like that. This voltage, okay, let me change polarity. It's something like that. VCMFB. What's this voltage? That voltage is just VB minus VCM rep. Yeah, same voltage will be developed there. Then, VCMFB will be just average of, this is a common mode output voltage, the average of those two voltages, plus that's the DC voltage, right? Later, we'll see that this is called a switch capacitor, switched capacitor. This is just a regular normal capacitor. Okay. C1 is a switched capacitor. Yeah, that switched capacitor is constantly charged to a DC voltage. So it loses all the information every time it's charged to a known fixed DC voltage. During phi 2 phase, this C1 capacitor is charged to this DC voltage, VB minus VCM rep, right? And then it pumps that charge into C2. So it's something like I have for example, it's something like that. C2, this R1 is T of C1. Okay, so the voltage is VB minus VCM, right? Something like that, okay? Now, this capacitor voltage will be eventually charged to VB minus VCM, right? Question.이게 안 달린 이유는 지금 이쪽이 낮은 전압이에요. 이쪽이 나중에 보면은 이쪽이 약간 하이고 이쪽이 로우 전압이에요. 그래서 지금 VDD 게이트가 VDD일 때 이건 늘상 ON이 돼요. 근데 얘는 전압이 좀 높아. ON이 안 되니까 이 컴플리멘트리 PMOS를 이렇게 달아서 CMOS 스위치로 한 거죠. 전압이 약간 높으니까. 밑에는 안 달아도 뭐 저 충분히 저항값이 나와가지고 나중에 이거 클락킹 할 때 시정수 RC 시정수가 이 클락 주기보다 훨씬 작아야 되거든요. 그 밑에는 VB 값이 VCM 랩보다 낮으므로 그래서 NMOS 하나 가지고도 충분한 저항이 나온다. 밑에 스위치 안 달면 VB가 전달할 방법이 없잖아. 그러니까 지금 라인 그러면 안 되지. 여기도 스위치 달고 그러니까 저 사람은 밑에만 안 단다고? 위에도 그 안 다른 김에 위에도 달지 말지. 왜 위에도 왜 달아? 똑같은데. 그거 좀 이상한데 짬뽕인데. 몰라. 어쨌든 달기 싫으면 다 안 달지 뭐. 그럼 뭐 탈락했지. 지금 쇼트 났잖아. 일단 얘하고 뭐 쇼트가 났을 거 아니까. 그제? 위에 거 이러면 쇼트가 나네. 그 VCM의 부위도 안 달아버리면은 뭐 얘가 DC 바이어스, 노미널 바이어스밖에 안 붙잖아. 그죠? 그러니까 그건 뭐 동작을 안 하는 것이고. 그래서 지금 이 전압을 만들어내려면 그렇게 스위치 캐패시터에다가 C를 딱 달아놓으면 몇번 클락킹을 열심히 해놓으면 그쪽으로 간다는 거지. 크게 상관없어. 크게 상관없어. 속도밖에 안 난다고요. TOC. 거의 다 똑같이 하죠. 똑같이 작게 만들었지. 뭐 그렇게 크게 상관이 없거든 이게. 그러니까 이게 RC 시정수 나중에 보면 이 RC가 아니고 이 스위치의 RC 시정수 이것 때문에 RC가 주기보다 꽤 작아야 되거든요. 상당히 작아야 돼. 그래야 이한 주기 클락 베이즈 동안 자기가 세트를 하거든. 그죠? 얘가 스위치장이 스위치장. 야, 이원철, 유어턴. 야, I want to skip some parts. So this is my fully differential op-amp. Differential input, yeah, differential output. So I have a tail current source here. I need a CMFB voltage here. Yeah, sometimes I can apply CMFB voltage there. But this one is a higher gain, less stable. So yeah, I apply the CMFB voltage here. 야, this is the first type. Differential CMFB circuit. This is my differential CMFB circuit. 그래서 I apply my output node there. Okay. This voltage is connected to there. Okay. Yeah, see here, see for the small signal wise, see this is VO positive. So this is GM6 times VO positive. Small signal must flow from drain to source. This is GM7 times VO negative. Yeah, I have some of those two, right? And and then some of those two will be developed there. This is only current source, right? So if I have some arrow here, then my small signal VCMFB will be GM6. GM6 and GM7 are the same. If it's 1-to-1, right? Then this voltage is applied there, you know. Then, you know, there is some from gate to drain, there is a negative voltage developed there, right? So, let's just see. Yeah, from here to here, there is a negative voltage. Let me see. Yeah, this is a loop gain, right? I started from VO there. VO negative there, then I came back to the same point, the VO here, right? So the gain from here, actually loop gain is this one for the gain for the CMFB circuit times GM5, RO2, RO5, something like that, right? So this is my loop gain for CMFB. Yeah, I can make a common mode circuit, see? For the, if I put those, see, if I connect those two together, I can generate a common mode circuit. Okay, where is my common mode circuit? Okay, here. So this is a simple CMFB circuit. And let's just see. Yeah, that's a VO, right? So, yes, I just overlap. How come it doesn't get out? Exit. Uh-oh. I have some something bothering me here. Okay. Uh-oh. Contrast. Oh, it's gone. All right. So, yeah, for the common mode circuit, this input and that input are the same. This output and that output are the same because I'm dealing with a common mode signal only. Okay? So yeah, those two, see, I just connect them together and make just a double. So let's see. Yeah, this is the input common mode voltage there, right? So there is a 2x times M1, there is a RO3 for M3, and twice M4 there. And then see, I go to this circuit, which is a twice M6 here, and then M8, M9, and then this is the CMFB voltage, right? Apply to there. So this is my common mode circuit, small signal common mode circuit. Yeah. So see, from here, you know, this will be my common mode output, right? Yeah, this is my common mode output. This is my common mode input. For this common mode signal, I have a negative feedback loop here. Yeah, this is my negative feedback loop. That loop gain reduces my common mode gain, okay? You know, without feedback, my common mode gain will be just 2GM1, yeah, by this. And then there is, this is just 1/2 RO4. Yeah, this is, this impedance is pretty large. So this is my common mode gain without feedback. Okay, just 2GM1, 1/2 RO4. Yeah, with a common mode feedback, I have to common mode feedback loop gain. Okay, I have to reduce it because of shunt feedback. Actually, it doesn't depend on shunt feedback. Anyway, it's something like my common mode output resistance is reduced by 1 plus loop gain for the common mode feedback circuit. Actually, here, see, yeah, any question? You want to no question yet? Okay. So, let me see. Yeah, we can calculate the unity gain frequency of a common mode feedback loop. See, to calculate the common mode feedback, I just cut here. Yeah, this is my CMFB circuit, right? So from here to here, yeah, this is a 2GM6, and then this is RO10, RO9. That's a voltage gain from here to here. One negative, negative, so it is positive until now. And then this goes there. Yeah, this may be a miller capacitor, right? I have this capacitor, but this capacitor will be this frequency compensation capacitor, right? So that should be my miller capacitor. So let's see. This is 1 plus S RO10 RO9 times that CC times that miller capacitor voltage gain is GM4 one half RO4, something like that. This impedance is huge. Okay. Yeah, and then what is the other one? Yeah, the other one is 2GM4. Is it 2GM4? Half RO4, something like that. So this will be my loop gain for common mode circuit. So you'll find it out here. So for this loop gain, see, my unity gain frequency is just put omega, delete it, and then if this is 1, that's my omega t, right? So that omega t is just GM6 over CC. GM6 is this thing, GM6 over CC. This is pretty low because I will have a small GM6 to increase this input voltage range of CMFB circuit. Question. Circuit 여기서 이게 잘안 왔어요? 지금 질문이 요 오른쪽 서클이 지금 무슨 서클인가 그 말인가요? 그러니까 커먼 모드만 다 끄집어낸 거죠. 그러니까 무슨 말인가 하면은 그러니까 커먼 모드 하면은 요두 개를 쇼트 시켜도 되잖아. 왜냐하면 인풋 커먼 모드가 동일하니까 같은 전압이니까. 그러니까 M1이 두 개가 병렬로 됐다고 해도 되죠. 마찬가지로 M4도 병렬, 왜냐면 이두 녀석들이 다 같아, 이게. 아웃풋도 두 개가 같아. 계속 병렬이 되죠. CMFB도 마찬가지. CC도 두 배가 되고, 뭐 이런 식이죠. CL도 두 배가 되고. 겹쳐버려요. 오케이, okay, so that unity gain frequency of a common mode feedback loop gain is usually pretty small, smaller than omega t of this amplifier itself. Yeah, this is a CMF we look again. Yeah, this again is pretty large. Oh, this time this is larger. This is a differential mode voltage gain. This is better. Say, I think they increased something. Is this GM5? GM6 of CC or something like that? Yeah, in this time, I think CL is much larger than CC. So let's talk about the triode CMFB circuit briefly. Yeah, see, this is a simple, fully differential amplifier. Yeah, I can put two PMOS transistor, which works in the triode region, and then that gate is connected to VO positive and VO negative. Okay, then. You know, this M4, M5 used to be my current source, right? And then I have a voltage-controlled resistor here. That's M6 and M7. Say, if my common mode is increased, common mode output is increased, then, you know, this voltage is increased, source gate voltage becomes smaller, this resistance becomes larger, okay? Then, this resistance becomes larger, then, let's see, there will be some voltage drop here, right? And then, so this current will be reduced. Is it right? Is it reduced? Okay, anyway, it will reduce that common mode output, negative feedback. So if this is increasing from gate to drain, it is reduced, right? Source to drain, it is reduced. There is a negative feedback, right? Yeah, M6 and M7 must work in the triode region, not in saturation. We can do similar thing to find a loop gain for common mode circuit.그게 current source 밑에 달려있어서 그래요, 주로. 뭐, 여기 달아도 되긴 되는데, 이게 사실은 current source잖아, 사실은, 그죠? current source에다가 saturation 영역에 동작하는 놈을 놓아버리면은, 이게 동작을 안 해요. 카런 소스로 동작을 못 하잖아. 그나마 여기 저항이 달려 있으면 좀 낫죠. 카런 소스인데, 그거 이 바이어스를 걸어놨는데, 이 DC 바이어스를 걸어놨겠죠. 이 DC 바이어스 걸어놨잖아. 그래서 지금 이 DC 바이어스의 전류를 조절하려고 이 저항을 조절해요. 저항이 작아야겠죠, 일단. 그러면 트라이오드 영역에서 동작해야 돼. 세츄레이션에 들어가면 저항이 커지죠. 그죠? 적어도 스몰 시그널 저항이 굉장히 커지죠. 그래서 지금 이 타입은 트라이오드에서 동작을 해야만 돼. 오케이, this is another type of triode type CMFB circuit. Yeah, here see my output voltage is connected to this type, this two MOS transistor. So they control the resistor. Okay, here. Say this is VO positive. This may be VO negative, right? So that this resistance is a function of output common mode voltage. Yeah, then let's see. I have a see in this type I have some reference voltage, you see. I want to set common mode output voltage to be same as this reference voltage, right? So here, see, how can I achieve that? Let's see. Reference voltage, yeah, here to there. Oh yeah. Okay. Okay, so let's see. We can calculate some loop gain. Maybe I can cut. So let's see. You know, I can apply. Say this is my common mode alpha voltages. I just cut here, find the loop gain. See, I have another input there, right? So, see, if you look at the, see, this is my common mode output. If this is increasing, this should be reduced, right? Positive or negative. Because it is a gate to drain. So, source to drain, it is still negative. Source to drain, negative, right? Those are all negative. Source to drain, negative. So from here to there, it is negative. It's a negative feedback. But let's see, from VLAB, if this is a positive, if this is a positive, this is a negative, right? This is a negative, yeah, negative. So from gate to drain, this is a positive. So you can see, from here to there, the voltage gain is a positive, okay? So then I have something like some gain times common mode alpha voltage minus VREV, right? Because the voltage polarity is positive. Okay? So yeah, see, if my CMFB loop gain is large enough, there is a virtual ground, there should be zero. Question. You want to ask question? No, not yet. Feedback은 안 걸렸지? 그냥 얘는 그냥 이어서 인가만 했지. 이 아웃풋이 이쪽 브랜치로는 넘어왔나? 안 넘어왔지. 그러니까 컨트롤이 이렇게만 가고만 있죠. VLAB은 그제? 얘는 넘어왔지? 이쪽은 넘어왔지? 요걸 통해가지고. 그니까, 이걸 이제 요 아웃풋을 따져보면은, 어쨌든 VLAB 쪽에서는 똑같은, 거의 같은 게인이지? 같은 게인 아닌가? 뭔가 어떤 게인을 타고 이렇게 넘어와서 요 아웃풋까지. 그래서 한번 보자. 여기서 커먼 모드도 넘어가고, 일단 내가 지금 우선 주장하는 게 얘가 서로 어떤 마이너스 관계에 있다는 거. 그래서 결국은 지금 요 회로를 내가 똑같이 만들어 놓으면은 요게 이제 레플리카예요. 레플리카. 복사를 했다는 거지. 얘하고 1대1이야. 간단하게 생각하면. 다 1대1로 만들어 놓으면은 결국 요거의 아웃풋 전압이 VLAB하고 같도록 조정된다는 거야. 폴래리티가 우선 마이너스라서. 그래서 그게 지금 이게 지금 피드백이 지금 안 걸려 있는데 어쨌든 얘가 이쪽으로 이렇게 VLAB이 이어와서 이 전류를 컨트롤하고 있죠. 이쪽 전류를, 그죠? 그 전류가 이렇게 컨트롤 되고 있고, 딴 거는 그렇게 돼가. 얘는 피드백이 아니라도 어떤 이런 관계가 성립한다. 야, here see, I have a slight matching problem because this transistor and that transistor should match each other. However, drain source voltage is quite different. Between M9 and M15, right? Yeah, to solve that matching problem, I just added this one there. See? same circuit. Then drain source voltage of M9 and 15 are the same. So independent of channel length modulation, yeah, they work. I mean, so we solve the matching problem. Okay. Question. Yuan sir, where are you? Ask a question. Okay. So yeah, another type of triode feedback CMFB circuit. Say yeah, this is a folded cascode op-amp, right? Basically, NMOS input. And then, you know, this transistor is active cascode, right? You know, yeah, we can just connect it, say, without those transistors, right? Those transistors, this is connected to some DC bias. Yeah, this is connected to the same DC bias. We can connect it directly like that, right? But we use the active cascode here. Say that active cascode thing is, this M12, see? This node is connected to there. And then I have an amplifier here, right? With a negative gain. This is my current source. So this amplifier gain boosts output resistance, right, of this M6. Yeah, this is nothing but active cascode, right? This is my active cascode. And then, yeah, triode feedback is here. There is a VCM reference, and this is my triode transistor. Yeah, in a triode transistor, my output voltage is less than NMOS threshold voltage. This doesn't work, right? So my output range is limited to be larger than threshold voltage. Output swing is limited. Yeah, if output voltage is smaller than threshold voltage, this doesn't work, right? It is off, so it cannot control anything. Yeah, question. No? All right, this is a most differential amplifier. Yeah, this is my CMFB circuit. Yeah, you can see. Yeah, those are outputs, right? Outputs. I may need a frequency compensation there. This is my main fully differential op-amp. So, yeah, for the small signal, this is VO positive, VO negative. This is my reference voltage, common mode reference voltage. Yeah, I can calculate the small signal current flowing that way. That's half GM6 VO positive minus VCM rep. This current. How about this current? This current is that current is same thing, half GM9, which is the same as GM6. VO negative minus VCM rep. Okay. So here, see, I have some of those two currents. Here, I have some of those two currents. This current mirror copies that. So here, I have twice of those, right? So, yeah, this CMFB voltage, small signal CMFB voltage is just twice of those currents, right? That's GM6, VO positive, VO negative, some of those two VCM rep times, this is the current, right? some output resistance here. Output resistance is some, yeah, R12 parallel, R7 parallel, R8, something like that. Question.앰프 게인이 어쨌든 투 스테이지거든. 얘가 이게 불안한 거죠. 이 앰프 게인은 좀 줄여야 돼, 물론. 그래서 나중에 여기에 디제너레이션 리지스터를 주로 넣어요. 그러면 그러니까 CMFB 게인이 이렇게 되는 것보다는 이렇게 그 저를 이렇게 되는 게 좋아요. 그러면 나가 액티브 그 아웃풋 액티브 레인지가 이렇게 넓어져요. 그래서 얘는 게인을 줄이려 그래. CMFB 그 회로는 일부러 소스 저항을 달아 가지고 줄이려 그래. WBL도 가능한 작은 게 좋죠. 예. 그런데도 불구하고 여기서 스몰 GM에다가 뭐 아웃풋 RO에다가 게인, 그러니까 완전히 게인이 1보다는 클 거 아니에요, 적어도, 그죠? 1보다는 크다고, 훨씬 크죠. 그래서 2 스테이지가 되는 거예요. 카먼 모드에서는 얘 1스테이지, 얘 2스테이지가 2스테이지 앰플리파이어가 되는 거야. 그래서 우리가 프리퀀시 컴펀세이션을 항상 하지. 안 그러면 카먼 모드가 안 잡혀. 퀘스천? 노? 'This is pretty small, right? 한번 못 쓸게. But actually, this is not very good enough. So I hope you just put source degeneration register to further decrease the GM of CMFB amplifier. 야, this is some simulation result. VO positive, VO negative. And this is differential mode Bode plot and common mode Bode plot. What is this thing? Oh yeah, this is source degeneration, right? So, where's my V? Yeah. Oh yeah. So this is my alpha, right? So this is my source degeneration register and then differential pair. So this is taken. Apply to differential pair, compare with the reference voltage. Yeah, this is applied there. The gain is not large, right? So I don't have a, the voltage gain from here to here is close to one, smaller than one. From here to there is not large, so I don't have a frequency compensation here. Yeah, this is just a source follow type CMFB circuit. So in this case, I think you can see this thing is a huge, huge W over here. For the source follow thing. Okay, question. No. Yeah, let's move to switch capacitor CMFB circuit. Yeah, this is a very convenient switch capacitor. So it is very fast. So it has a very large unity gain frequency for the CMFB loop. Yeah, one disadvantage, switching. So this switched capacitor CMFB circuit cannot be used for analog amplifier. Okay, for the switched capacitor circuit, we can. Yeah, if this op amp is used for switched capacitor circuit, we can use a switched capacitor CMFB circuit. However, if you want to use this circuit for analog amplifiers, we cannot use a switched capacitor CMFB. Because of switching, there is a lot of switching noise induced here. Okay, for an analog amplifier. But if this op amp is used for switched capacitor circuit, yeah, it just wait until all the transient dies out, right? Then this switch capacitor CMF is okay.어떻게 해요? 얘를 아날로그, 이제 어떻게 아날로그 아주 미세한 신호를 내가 잡아내려고 이렇게 쓰고 있는데, 여기 스위치 캐패시터 CMFB를 이렇게 달아버리면은, 얘가 매일 이렇게 펄스를 이렇게 쿵작쿵작 하는 바람에, 아날로그 욕 가다가 한퐁 튀고, 이런 일들이 계속 일어나야. 이게 귀찮죠. 스위칭이 이게 들어가 버려. 그러니까 나는 이런 매끈한 이런 신호를 원하고 있는데, 이 녀석이 가다가 한 번씩 퐁 튀고 뭐좀 이상해. 그죠? 스위치 캐패시터? 이런 애플리케이션이 아니고 스위치드 캐패시터에 우리 오피앰프를 써요. 스위치드 캐패시터 인티그레이터, 스위치드 캐패시터 필터, 다음 챕터에 나올 건데. 스위치드 캐패시터 인티그레이터는 간단하게 하면은 이런 거예요. 예를 들자면은 뭐 여기다가 입력을 이렇게 물어놓으면은 51 페이지든 이렇게가 요 캐패시터를 이렇게 충전시켜 놔요. 그리고 52 페이지일 때는 잘못했네. 52가 여기 있어야 되는데. 그래서 52 페이지일 때는 어떻게 되냐면은 이렇게 꼭 물어버리면은 이게 버추얼 그라운드가 돼서 결국 차지가 다 빠져나가야 돼. 요 마이너스 Q가 이쪽으로 이사를 가서 여기다가 추가가 되죠. 이 Q는 0으로 가, 0. 결국 이 버추얼 그라운드니까 나중에는 결국 마이너스 Q 차지가 0 차지로 가야 돼. 여기 있던 마이너스 Q가 어딜 가냐면 여기 이사를 가서 여기 더해지는 거예요. 그 요런 게 스위치드 캐패시터 인티그레이터예요. 요런 OPAMP일 때는 스위치드 캐패시터 CMFB가 no problem. 그 아날로그 아까처럼 이런 아날로그 스위치 캐패시터 썼다가는 망한다. 노이즈 때문에. 스위칭 노이즈 때문에. 같은 걸 써도 돼요. 보통 아마 같은 거쓸 거야. 같은 거. 그래서 그니까 한 주기 동안 기다려줘. CMFB도 세트를 할 때까지 기다리고. 얘 처음에 얘 보면 아웃풋이 처음에는 복잡하게 나와요. 이게 세트라면 클락이 이렇게 뻑뻑뻑뻑 뜨고 있다 치면은 처음에는 쿡 해가지고 쿡은 이거 뭐 이래가지고 한참 있다가 요때는 이제 쓸수 있는 데이터인데 이걸 못 쓰는 데이터예요. 그래서 그건 버리고 요것만 나중에 톡 읽어가 다음에서 다음 페이지에서. 그래서 여기서는 뭐좀 틀려도 괜찮아요. 틀려져 있어도 여기는 CMFB도 정확하게 가 있어야 돼. 여기는 VCMFB도 세트라고 다 세트를 해야 돼. 오케이, any other question? No? Yeah, so this CMFB, this there is a switch capacitor block is here, right? It accepts output, two outputs, some common mode reference, nominal bias. So this is I will put just VB, say for nominal bias. So my CMFB will be just like that. VB plus half output voltage. This is a common mode output minus VCM reference. So you know the voltage gain of output node to this CMFB voltage is just voltage gain of 1. I don't need any frequency compensation because CMFB circuit has a voltage gain of only 1. Okay? Okay. Yeah, let's go to this CMFB circuit. Yeah, those are my output node voltages here and there. And then this is my CMFB voltage. Those are nominal bias VB. This is my nominal bias. Nominal bias voltage. This VCM rev is my common mode reference voltage. So I want to set common mode output voltage same as VCM rev. Okay? So during by two phase, those two switches are on. These switches are on. Those switches are off. Okay? Yeah, those by one, by two clocks are non-overlapping clocks. Say something like that. Yeah, this is my non-overlap clock. This is switches on, off. This is switches off, on. So they are never on together, simultaneously, right? Only one switch is on. So here, see, yeah, as we mentioned briefly, this actually switched capacitor is switched capacitor is say, yeah, it accepts some charge, and then let's see, say for this C1, it accepts some charge, right? This charge like C1 VB minus VCM rep. It accepts some charge like that. And then during by one phase, see switches on. Those switches are on, right? This switch is off during by one phase. So I just connect C1 in parallel with C2. So, their voltage should be same because of that parallel connection. Okay? If C1 equals C2, their charge will be the same, right? 아, 보통 1대1로 많이 해요. C1 equals C2. 처음에 0 됐으면 그렇겠지? 얘가 0이 됐으면은 처음에 그 얘가 0이라 칩시다. 그러면 얘 차지가 와서 딱 붙여버리면 2분의 1이 되겠지? 서로 2분의 1씩 갈랐겠지? 그 다음에 요또 끊고서는 여기 가서 얘가 1을 또 받아와. 또 이래 팡 붙여버리면은 어떻게 되나? 똑같아지면은 1.5니까 0.75씩 되겠지? 0.75씩. 그렇죠? 그리고 그 다음 녀석은 또 잊어보고 얘는 이 0.75는 또다 잊어버리고 다시 1이 되는 거예요. 그게 스위치 캐패시터예요. 옛날 정보는 다 까먹어버리고 다시 어떤 전압으로 리셋돼버린 그게 스위치드 캐패시터라. 또 1을 받아와가지고 더땡 해보면은 1하고 0.75니까 뭐 어떻게 되겠지? 그것도 절반, 요 1하고 0.75의 중간으로 또갈 거야. 어떻게? 그리고 한참 놔두면 이 녀석도 1이 돼 있겠지. 결국 계속 이렇게 펌핑해가지고 줘버리면 그죠? 처음에는 0이었는데. 그러니까 결국은 한참 하다 보면은 요 C2 전압값이 그냥 VB 빼기 VCM 랩으로 가 있다는 거지. 여러 번 스위칭을 하다 보면은. 시원이 작으면 더 오래 걸리겠지, 그지? 이 펌핑하는 때 오래 걸리겠지? 응? 거꾸로 해도 되겠지. 근데 뭐 여기서 힘이 많이 들겠지. 이거 차징하는데. 그러니까 예를 들어서 이 시정수 같은 것도 이게 아 스위치 온, R 스위치 저항하고 이 C1이 이저 클락 프리퀀시보다는 피리어드가 꽤 작아야 이게 세틀이 되게 되겠어요. 그래서 C1을 너무 또 키우면 좀 불편해. 느리게 해야 되거든. 느리게. 그래서 뭐 귀찮아서 같이 하죠, 같이. C1 equals C2. 예. 그래서 한참 펌핑하다 보면은 이 전압으로 가 있다는 거지. 오케이. So, let's see. Yeah, if I assume this voltage is the same as VB minus VCM rep, both of them. See, then you can derive this CMFB voltage is, yeah, so, you know, VB minus VCM lab, though, plus this voltage. Yeah, that voltage is just average, okay? Yeah, this is my CMFB voltage, the desired equation, okay? Both phi 1 and phi 2 phase. Yeah, so I said this C1 is a switched capacitor. Switched capacitor is usually I put equivalent resistor. This is that switching period. Yeah, C2. Okay. So this voltage is VB minus VCM lab. So eventually, for long period of time, this C2 voltage will be same as that voltage. This RC Lopez filter, okay?이게 저항이에요, 저항. Equivalent 저항. Equivalent 저항이 그렇게 되는 거예요. 나 스위치드 캐패시터에서는. 스위치드 캐패시터에서 저항은 전압 나누기 전류인데, 그 에버리지를 따져요, 에버리지. 그러니까 이 에버리지는 뭐냐? 한번 들어가는 차지를 T로 나눠주면은 얘가 에버리지 전류라고 정의가 돼요. 그래서 요 녀석이 얼마가 되냐면은 델타 Q가 얼마가 되냐면은 C 곱하기 V인가 이렇게 돼. 델타 Q가. 그래서 이 저항값이 T of C가 되는 거죠. 이퀴벌런트 저항값이. 그래서 스위치드 캐패시터는 매일 차지를 받아가서 까먹어버리고 다음에 와서는 또 달라고 그래요. 또 차지를. 그래서 항상 받아가서 에너지를 잊어버려. 또 달라 그래. 그러니까 그게 저항의 역할을 하는 거죠. 자기가 저장을 못하고선 어디서 다 잊어먹고 왔어. Question. No? 오케이. Let's move non-overlap clock generator. You see SR latch. What's the SR latch? Yeah, see, this is my latch circuit. Yeah, if this is a set bar maybe, set, just a set, this set. If this is one, so this will be my Q. This may be my Q bar. That's my SR latch. See, if this set is one, this Q will be one. Okay. If this reset is one, my Q will be zero. Yeah, that's SR latch, right? Then for the non-overlap clock generator, see, I just put. See what happens if I have a reset is this bar. You know, then, see, it's something like that. See, if this is a clock, if clock is 1, so it's just a set, right? My Q will be 1 because this is a setting because this is 1, 0, right? So it's just a set. This is reset, right? If clock is 0, then this R is 1, so it just reset. Okay, something like that. Okay? Yeah, if I have some delay element in between here and there. See, I have a delaying element like a 4 inverter delay is there. Then, yeah, this phi 1 and phi 2 will be, phi 1 will be something like that. Phi 2 will be something like that. So I have some non-overlap, right? What's this non-overlap time? Non-overlap time is, I think, this 5 inverter delay, is it right? This delay and those delays, eh? Yeah, let me check. See, yeah. So, my clock is high. Yeah, I assume my clock becomes a high, then this becomes a zero, right? This will be zero. After some time, this will be zero, right? After some delay, this goes to zero, and then this goes to, let's see, should be one, and let me see. Say from here, see, after 5 inverter delay, this goes to 1. Yeah, it used to be 1. And this, so after 10 inverter delay, my by 1 changes. Say from this T1 plus 10 inverter delay. Is it positive? 10 TDIMV. Something like that. How about that one? I think this is a 5 inverter delay. 5 inverter delay. So from here to here, 10. From here to here, that's only 5 inverter delay. Okay? My non-overlap time is 5 inverter delay. If I use this clock, they never turns on simultaneously, right? If they turn on simultaneously, I got trouble, right? If it's all on at the same time, then I have some trouble, right? So I don't want that one in switch capacitor. So they should be non-overlap. Non-overlap means they never turn on at the same time, simultaneously. Okay. Yeah, that's about it. You can derive. So, yeah, any question? Oh, whose turn? Yuanzhi's turn? Yeah, Yuanzhi, ask a question, anything. Huh? Question? No? Then I can ask you a question then. Huh? Let's see. Do I have a question? Oh, question. Transmission gate. 그 별로예요, 별로. 그러니까 왜 그런가, 왜 별로냐면은 transmission gate는 기본적으로 R이에요, R. 이런 녀석이 있으면은 이 C가 붙을 것이고. 뭐 이렇게 하면은 갈수록 멍해져. 내가 요런 펄스를 넣으면은 요렇게 되고, 또 다음에 트랜스미션 게이터 뭐 이렇게 되고 이렇게 되죠. 근데 인버터를 넣으면은 갈수록 똑똑해져. 인버터는 앰플리파이어니까 스위치는 저항이고, 우리 이런 걸 원하지. 갈수록 똑똑해지는 놈을 원하지. 아니요, 그래도 똑똑해. 인버터는 항상 지연이 약간 있잖아, 그지? 그래서 이 따져보면은 자기 온 저항에다가 로드 캐패시터 이게 비례하는데, 온 저항이 그냥 one of GM인가 이렇게 돼요. 그 saturation region. 그래서 얘는 항상 앰플리파이어가 있으니까 샤프하게 만든다고. 더 샤프하게 만드는 게 자기의 기능이야. 얘는 뭐 그냥 저항인데, 뭐 저항이니까 뭉그러지는 수밖에. 아, 누가 증폭기가 없어서 소스에서 드레인 가면서 증폭이 안 되는 거예요. 게인이 1보다 작아. 얘는 게인은 아무리 멍한 인버터라도 게인은 1보다 크죠. 아무리 느린 인버터라도. 게인이 1보다 크면 이렇게 다 샤프해져요, 갈수록. 그럴 것 같잖아. 게인이 1보다 크면, 그제? 더 빨리 샤프해지죠. 오케이. Oh, yeah. Did I verify that? Non-overlap time, I think, yeah, this 5 inverter delay. You can check from this timing diagram. Okay.